Welcome. In this video, we will discuss about the 12th Griha Summit. So recently, the inaugural summit for the Griha was organized, and the major idea behind organizing this particular summit was to discuss on innovative technology which could help in building green buildings. So just remember, Griha is actually associated with the green building construction. In this video, we will discuss about what Griha is, what are the various details associated with it, and on which parameters it actually decide the greeniness of a building. So let's start. The full form of Griha is actually Green Rating for Integrated Habitat Assessment, or what is Griha? It is the national rating system of India for any completed building construction. So this is the Indian system in which it decides the rating system on the greeniness component on any completed building construction. So just remember, it takes care of completed building construction. And this is a Indian system. So these are the few little bit of trivia you should know. Then Griha is recognized as the India's own green building rating system in India's intended nationally determined contribution. So are you guys aware of that India or other countries also have agreed to have intended nationally determined contribution under which framework? So it is the framework of your UNFCCC, and the agreement which we know is the Paris Agreement. So India has made commitment under the Paris Agreement for the INDC, and in that the Griha is considered the India's green building rating system. So this is again something you should know. Now this is also a cue for you to go and revise about the Paris Agreement. It was conceived by the Energy and Resource Institute, or what we call as TERI, and developed jointly with the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy. So which are the two institutions associated with Griha? So the ministry is the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy. So just remember, it is not the Ministry of Environment. No, it is not the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. No, it is not that. But it is the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy, which has worked with the institute known as the TERI, which is a leading institute in India in terms of research in energy. So in fact, this is the one which recognized or which organized the World Development Summit. So World Sustainable Development Summit is organized by the TERI. So this is again additional information you could know. So what will you understand from this slide is that Griha is India rating system. It is the one which India is using in the INDC, which is under the Paris Agreement, and it is conceived by the TERI along with the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy. Now let's move forward and try to know little bit more about the objective. So why the Griha came into picture and what are its underlying objective? So it help to design green buildings and in turn help evaluate greeniness of the building. So that is also a fact that it will help that the buildings are constructed green. And because it is a rating system, it will rate the buildings on the greenness they have actually encompassed in their designing and in their construction. So that is how the Griha is going to help. The system has been developed to help design and evaluate new building. So that is also a part of the objective of Griha, that it will work to develop for the buildings that are still in inception stage. They will work for the design and evaluation, because once the building is constructed, you can only go ahead with the rating that it has not been green. But that shouldn't be the motive. The motive would be to have more designs incorporated while constructing a building so that it eventually become a green building. So that is why one of the other objective is to go for the help in the development of design and then evaluate. A building is assessed based on its predicted performance over its entire life cycle. So now this is also important, that it's not like when it is constructed what has been the greeniness at that time, but the entire cycle, what kind of effect it will have over the environment throughout the time it is expected to be there. It will help in reducing the GHG emissions, reduce energy consumption and the stress on natural resources. So one of the idea for an example of having green building is to be energy efficient. So right now, these days you must have seen that many of the houses have got smart system, the smart lighting system, which means that whenever you move around, it will switch on the light. When you move out, it will switch off the light. So that is one of the way through which the energy could be conserved. The electricity would be conserved, and electricity, which we know in India, is produced mainly from coal. So eventually you are helping in reducing the GHG emissions in general. And once we reduce the energy consumption, you can always open up for the more resources, and hence will reduce the stress which is right now put on the natural resources. So this is actually how, or what you say, the ultimate goal of having a rating system is that to improve the green building, or to create more and more green building in the Indian territory, and through which it will help in reducing the GHG emissions. So this is something you should remember. Now quickly, let's just see what are the parameters on which it actually rate a building. So it rate a building on the basis of site selection and planning. For an example, if you are really locating a building near a industry, or industry which is what we call as the red industry, then you are actually like posing more problem than the solution. So site selection is one of the parameter. Conservation and efficient utilization of resources, like you have not constructed by harming the natural ecosystem of that particular area, and you have adopted the best conservation practices. Then building operation and maintenance, how much energy would be consumed in maintaining that building, whether you have utilized the optimized measures for it, that is again one of the parameters on which a building will be rated. And finally, the innovation points also. How innovative you have gone ahead with the material you have used, with the kind of design you have used, the spatial requirement, all these things are incorporated while designating any building as a green building. So these are the parameters on which the Griha is actually rated. So I hope you have understood this video. Just remember, Griha is the Indian system of rating a greenness of a building, and this is important for the perspective of going forward, what kind of global gas emission India is emitting, and that is one of the important factor in terms of the infrastructure and construction field as well. So I hope you have understood this video. If you have any doubt, feel free to drop a comment. Thank you.